Yo bendigo a Catalina la Grande.
¿Te vas a hacer llamar la Grande?
Por supuesto.
Te hace ver arrogante.
Lo sería si no fuera grande, pero lo soy. Solo estoy diciendo las cosas como son.
Claro.
I think, you know, season one, like you said, was all Mariel in her most angry way, trying to revenge her destatusing as into a servant. And then, like, season two is just like, I like to think of it as the blossoming of Mariel, where she just kind of opens up and relaxes, and she learns how, she relearns how to enjoy life. I think that's what season two is for Mariel. And that includes love and sex and friendships and food. And I think, you know, yeah, it's, we see a much happier Mariel in season two.
Jovencita, hay un rumor por toda Europa de que le quitaste Rusia a tu esposo.
Eres mi esposa. No puedes gobernar a Rusia sin que haya matanzas.
Sí puedo. Voy a ganar.
Me encanta que lo creas. Es peligroso. Lo quiero matar lentamente hasta
la razón y compasión le ganan a la violencia en cualquier argumento.
Hay que decapitarlo como hombre civilizado.
I think, you know, one of the things that Mariel most admires in Catherine is her optimism, which is something that Mariel just doesn't have. You know, she's very cynical. And I think, although she mocks Catherine's sort of naive optimism, I think she truly admires it and finds the fact that she's so hopeful and believes in herself so much. You know, and also, it's not an easy thing to lead a coup and then take over the throne from your husband. I mean, you know, even I in 2021 think that that is extraordinary that that woman actually did that. That's, you know, this is an unusual thing, even by modern standards. So I think, yes, Mariel's sort of like, wow, she's ballsy. And of course, Mariel loves her.
Tenemos que actuar rápido. Reedifiquemos a Rusia, mi amigo.
Todos esperan que dure un año.
Estoy a salvo hasta que nazca el bebé.
Debe ser raro que un humano crezca en tu interior. ¿Nunca has dudado? ¿Y si trae una navaja?
La verdad, no.
I don't think it's changed the way I view it. I think that I absolutely, completely see and agree with what Tony McNamara is saying about the the corruptibility of power, but also that, you know, as long as capitalism is in place, then, you know, these kind of liberal ideas that she has, like, no one's interested because they're like, there's no money to be made from a woman's school, you know, and that's what you see the world over, really. It's like the problem with climate change, right? But I think, yeah, it's also, you can have a woman in power, but actually, as we all know, you know, the prime minister or the president doesn't really hold the power. It's the people on the back, you know, in our country, it's the back benches, what they call them, that hold a lot of the power. And so in her day in Russia, you know, yes, she may be the empress, but all the nobles around her think that she likes to fuck horses. And that's what they think of her, you know. So, yeah, I think it's very clever the way that you see those echoes between the show and the modern day politics. It's very chimes with us, doesn't it?